Good morning, class. I'm back with the lab project number three overview. And today I'm going to give you an overview of the monthly budget due on 19th. So I would like you to click on the Excel project number three and click on open with. Just make sure you need to click on enable editing. And then save it either on your desktop or on the flash drive. So in this particular activity, it's going to be very interesting for you to complete this. So this is personal monthly budget. And here, what I have, so many of you have an idea of savings, what's coming in, what's going out. So in terms of expenses and incomes, and what's your end monthly balance. But in this project, I made it interesting in a way that you have projected monthly income, projected monthly balance, monthly income and actual monthly income. Similarly, in your expenses, you will see you have housing expense, transportation, entertainment, loans, taxes, insurance, and so on. And I would like you to complete first this portion, which is getting the projected monthly income and actual income, then do all the expenses. Once you complete the expense, you're going to do the total of the projected cost and the actual cost. And the difference, and finally you're going to complete the top portion, which is the end of the monthly balance. So if you think in very transparently, all I'm trying to understand that what's your end balance. And in order to get the end monthly balance, you need to know your income, your expenses. So income subtract expenses, that gives you the balance. So let's do the first one. I'm going to show you a few of them and I would like you to complete on your own. So in the first one, you see the projected monthly income. What you need to do here is, again, you can either do the addition by simply just, clicking on that cell equal this, which is plus E7, and that's going to give you 4,600. Similarly, actual monthly income, which you can either do like this, the way I have shown you, or you can click on auto sum. That's E10 to E11, then enter, done. Now, let's do one of the expenses. In one of the expenses, you can easily do the auto sum technique because that's going to save the time because there are so many expenses under housing. So let's do the projected cost first and let's get the subtotal for the actual cost. Auto sum again, done. Now, in terms of getting the differences, so what's the difference? Like, now that I know the projected cost and the actual cost, you're going to do the equal symbol and then D15, which is your actual cost, subtract projected cost, which is C15. Press enter, and that's going to give you zero because 1000 minus 1000 is zero. Now, imagine that you have to do all of these, that's going to be like very time consuming work for you. So in order to save the time, we're going to use the copying formula, which I have shown you in the lab project number two. So in terms of copying the formula, you just need to do it once for the first time, and then simply just drag it all the way in up to here, which is E25, release the mouse, and you will see the copying technique is done for you. Anything in the bracket, it's negative. And the rest are, the plus symbol. So again, let's do another one. Projected cost, auto sum, done. Simple, again, one more. Actual cost, auto sum, done. Differences, equal symbol, actual cost, subtract, projected cost, and that's going to give you zero one more time. And in terms of copying the formula, just make sure you see the plus icon all the way in the lower right hand corner and then drag it, release the mouse, that does it automatically for you. So I hope you can do the rest, all these, the rest of the expenses. Now I want to take you to the total projected cost, which is the total expenses for projected. Here you need to do one at a time. So equal symbol, we need to just simply add one subtotals at a time for the projected cost. So all of these, you have to do it. Plus C35 plus C42, even though I did not complete, so but again, I'm making sure, like, you know, you need to complete that in order to get the right answer. Complete. So C48 plus C56 plus, then do the rest here, which is entertainment plus loans 40. Done. And the last one, age 59. So because I selected the last one, you don't need to put plus anymore. But as you can see here in the formula bar, it shows you all the cell that I have selected, and it shows also in the total projected cost cell here as well. So once I have completed selecting all the cells accurately, I'm going to press the enter, and that's going to give me the answer. But again, this is not the accurate answer, class. Just, you know, make sure I hope you're following. So it's 1807 for now because I did not complete the rest of them. So let's see if I complete one of these, personal care. I'm going to do the auto sum. Done. And now you can see the number changes. Same thing. Done. And then the difference is this minus this. Okay. Then you copy. That's going to give you the rest of the answers. So I hope you can do the total projected cost like this, like, you know, adding all the cells which is associated with the projected cost. Similarly, actual cost, same way. And then finally, the differences, which is actual minus projected cost, that's going to give you the differences. So again, equal this, subtract this, will give you the difference. Again, this is not an accurate answer. So I'm going to go back all the way on the top, which is the last piece I need to get done. So now I have the monthly income and I have all the expenses done, assuming. And finally, I will get to the projected balance. So which is projected income minus expenses. What is projected income? It's here, right? So let's do it. Equal this, which is E8, subtract the expenses. So where are all my expenses? I already did it, which is this one, right? So J61, then press enter, and that's gonna give me the calculation for the total projected balance. Similarly, once I know this, which is the actual monthly income minus, once I calculate this, which is the actual cost, and then press enter, that's going to give me the total actual income. I'm sorry, the balance. Now coming back to the difference for the actual income minus projected income. So again, this is very simple. It's already giving you the formula here. Equal symbol. The actual income is here. Subtract. The projected monthly income is here. Press enter. And that's 100. So again, I'm not doing the whole thing for you because otherwise you will, that defeats the purpose of learning. I would like you to continue with the rest. I did few of them, so I hope that's helpful. And even, like, you know, you're trying and you're getting the wrong answers, just, you know, keep on trying. And look at the webinar instructions carefully. You should be able to complete this whole thing and will be able to achieve the right answers. So it's not about getting the right answer, it's all about doing it correctly. Okay, so and that's all about it, class. Okay, thank you so much. Bye-bye.